got two teams who will look to their running backs to try to control the pace of the game. It's Melvin Gordon's Chargers going up against Bell's Steelers. The towels are out, but it's set to be a cold one at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. That's where we'll say hello to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, despite the elements, these fans here in Western Pennsylvania, they wouldn't dream of missing this one as you get a look inside snowy Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. Moments ago, a scene that's played here since 2004. Big Ben Roethlisberger greeted by this sold-out Heinz Field crowd. His Steelers getting set to match up with the Los Angeles Chargers. Welcome again, one and all. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Brandon Gordon on hand alongside Charles Davis. And yes, the storyline here, the weather. Snow and more of it expected as this game continues. So how will that impact how this one goes?
Can these teams ignore the distraction and the strangeness of playing in a snow game? Because it actually affects the crowd as well. That big roar you get is often muffled when there's a snow game. And the second part, what's the footwear you got on? Does that fit the turf you're playing on? And how will it handle as things get a little bit slick?
So the Steelers' offense getting set for their first drive. They'll be led out by their 35-year-old quarterback in his 14th year now, Ben Roethlisberger.
Is it really true that last year he became just the 10th player in NFL history to top 300 career touchdown passes?
How about that?
I mean, where is time gone? I feel like it was his rookie year, and he had that great winning streak to start off his career with the Pittsburgh Steelers. But the best part about his game, two Super Bowl rings.
And his fifth Pro Bowl a year ago as well. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And that'll bring up second down. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. That one goes for 24 yards.
And Martavis Bryant back in the fold, which delights not just himself, but of course his quarterback, Ben Roethlisberger. This guy, he can do it all, Brandon, able to go across the middle and stave off contact and make catches.
Sat out last year, as you're alluding to. Year before, though, 50 catches, 765 yards, and 6 touchdowns. Roethlisberger will throw. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
I know everyone wants that prototypical wide receiver, you know, the 6'3", 200-plus-pound guy, like a Julio Jones and A.J. Green and Dez Bryant. Antonio Brown just shatters that, doesn't he? Smaller in stature, but still able to use his quickness, his elusiveness, and his strength to create big plays.
Man open right side, it's Rodgers. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. So four plays, Charles, all passes here on the opening drive and already in the red zone.
And even if you're planning for them to throw the football a lot, on the opening drive, if they go 4-for-4 on you, you're off balance on defense. I've been there before. And part of you keeps thinking, they've got to run it at some point, right? They've got them really mixed up at this point. If I were them, I'd keep pressing the advantage. They're throwing it really well.
And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. 12 more yards there and another first down.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
As I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
Offense working with a second and goal now from the 3. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
A great job to hold him to just a yard there. Now it's 4th and goal.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, like hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Fourth down, here's Roethlisberger. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gotta let that happen, guys. Zach are going to play, and they responded to the challenge.
And he's gonna fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and six.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy they didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
Back near his goal line, Rivers. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
But he certainly didn't waste any time throwing some deep passes here. But the defense, it wasn't unexpected. They told their secondary, be ready. You're going to be tested all night by this team.
Here's a carry for Oliver. And I don't know if he made it out of the end zone. No signal. Yes, it's a safety. Well, we thought these two defenses, they might come to play. One has already come to play here, a safety for the opening points of the game.
Brandon, let's file this play away because if it turns out to be a tight game, who knows? This could wind up being the difference.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well, and they free kick it from the 20 now. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
They get the tackle, Marcus still Gilbert, second round pick back in 2011 out of Florida. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. Bryant with a catch right side. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pick up there, 26 yards. You know, when I see passes like that, I'm reminded of something you and I talked about yesterday. Big Ben was a wide receiver the first 3 years of high school, sitting behind the coach's son, and then he finally got that opportunity. I think he's made the most of it.
It's always the coach's son, isn't it? But you know where it helps him? When he looks downfield, he knows what the receivers are going to do. He actually has wide receiver's eyes when he's throwing the ball.
They went right back to him there, figuring one big play deserves another. You think maybe he called for it and said, hey, give me the ball again?
I think a lot of people operate under the whole idea of if they haven't stopped it, go until they do. You go right back at a guy because maybe his confidence might not be as high. In this case, he responded well. That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
And he will have a first down here at about the 40. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. Well, maybe that'll help him settle back into a groove after the interception on the first drive here, picking up the first to start drive number two.
And it is just starting over, isn't it? Sometimes it's just how you have to do it. You have to erase things from your mind. Don't worry about what happened before, because over the course of a game, the good players, things turn out pretty well for them, and that's what he's trying to do here.
On second down, it's Bell. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Only one score in the first quarter, and it came from the defense. And it's the Steelers with the early lead. More from the Steel City coming up after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers.
Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and ten. Now Roethlisberger to throw. He's to the 10. Over the middle here to Brown. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the 1. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
In order to be a great player, you have to be consistent. Antonio Brown is definitely that. 4 straight seasons with 100 or more catches.
How many more years do you think he can put up that type of production?
I think at least another 4 in a row, because their offense is built to get him the football, whether it's outside, inside, and he's a featured guy, and I think that he really, really wants to continue at this pace.
They'll try and run it in with Bell, and he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell punching it in from a yard away, and the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight-ahead power, and they got it done.
Boswell on now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Charger offense making their way back out there. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. And they don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward. Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
This is Gordon as they go to him again. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play, because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled, except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. A chance for us to look at this Chargers defense again. And they gave up a touchdown last drive. You kind of need to hit the reset button after every touchdown given up, Charles.
I love that. And the way that you phrased it is perfect, because from series to series, you can reset how the game is going to go. If you gave up a touchdown before, it doesn't mean you have to do it again. And if you made a great play before, you have to reset again anyway, because they're going to attack. So I love the way you phrased it and put it out there. That's what they have to do in this series.
Not like when you're playing a video game. You can't hit the reset button here. Let's go.
No, you shouldn't anyway. That's for sure.
Going deep here. He's got a man complete.
Holding offense.
Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
Here's Roethlisberger. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's brought down after a good game. That goes for a gain of 31. On 1st and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
He's thrown one interception already, and that doesn't necessarily mean the rest of the game is going to go like that. but it does seem that he's a little bit off in his approach to this one.
Yeah, it does, and that was a risky throw right there.
Got to be careful about taking care of the ball, making sure you get back within yourself. I mean, those mechanics that they work on all the time, they're there for a reason. Kind of get back to those and maybe tamp it down a little bit.
Second and 10, it's Roethlisberger once more. Going deep here for Bryant. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. Well, he's been the guy already over 100 yards here in the first half. Could have had a lot more if he would have been able to haul that one in.
Yeah, in fact, our statistician Marvin was already handing me a piece of paper with that yardage totaled on it. He thought that catch was going to happen just as you and I did as well.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. And the Chargers coming out of the field now.
This is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
And he's brought down after a good game. That one goes for 24 yards. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they?
Yeah,
when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
The penalty. Here's Gordon. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
Rivers now from the 50. And it's complete to Antonio Gates. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. So a minute 55 to go in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, while the two of us head for warmer areas of the press box, yes, we'll be sending you to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half.
Send me to Orlando, please.
Don't be so soft.
Rivers now, the throw on first down. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. He was trying to hit Melvin Gordon there, and it's second down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success.
Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Ryan Shazier in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop it for a loss of about 10. So it's third and long for the Chargers, and Rivers after the sack. From the gun, Rivers. Gates has it over the middle. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Do you get the sense, Brandon, that people are trying to retire Antonio Gates? They keep thinking this is almost the end of the line, and then he keeps making catches like the one we just saw there.
He's the old reliable, you're right, just one of 9 players in the NFL with 100 or more touchdowns. Yeah, he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
They'll try and punch it in. Gordon. And he is knocked down from the side, right at the line of scrimmage. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. Second down, Rivers. Got a man, it's Allen for the Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen from 3 yards out, and the Chargers have made this a one-score game. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line. Martavis Bryant in the offense getting set to go again here. He's been really good in the yardage category, yet to hit the end zone, however.
A minor blemish against him right now because the work he's doing catching the ball, in some ways he's helping serve as good ball control. Because the
trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dwight Lowry. Last year, the Chargers 5-11, so you wouldn't think that they would be tied for the league lead in interceptions, but they were, Charles, with 18.
And now they just need their offense, if they're going to do that again in 2017, to take advantage of and put more points on the board.
Try to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Artie Burns. A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. He also had an interception return for a touchdown last year. Another one there. What's the goal for a defensive back? One a season?
One a season is really
fantastic.
Way more than you would expect. I mean, guys set those type of goals, but rarely are they reached, rarely they achieve. To be able to pull it off back-to-back seasons, who says no one makes house calls anymore?
So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. Phillip Rivers now gears up to lead the offense on the field. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get him back into the ballgame or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking for that second touchdown now. So we reach halftime here in the Steel City with the Steelers on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports halftime report. Larry?
All right, Brandon, back to you guys in a minute. But first, it's indeed.
Well, my apologies, Larry. I wanted to hear the report. Somebody's in a hurry, so we're going to get them right to quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors. But overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Now a play fake here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Ryan Shazier coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. Now Rivers going to give to Gordon on the draw. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. He had a great read there from his free safety position. And, Charles, you know with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser-focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what...
And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Ryan Shazier in there to drop it for his second sack now here tonight. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
An unbelievable punt there. We're talking 70-plus yards. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number 2. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room.
They've got his man complete. And he's brought down after a good game. Again. Ain't a 32 that time. And the offense lining up first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Going deep here for Bryant. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll get it down deep into Los Angeles territory. It's a big play there for the Steelers. 42 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Second and 10 now. It's Roethlisberger. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game-changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with 2 straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying no more. We're making a stand right here, right now. But it is 3rd and 10. They got to get after him one more time.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up 4th. So put another 3 on the board, and all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the 3rd quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Chargers getting set to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs. and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Chargers are able to make this a close game again.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. The decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now the Chargers, their defense heading back out there. And a field goal surrendered the last time out. Just by and large, are field goals wins for the defensive side?
They certainly are in today's football because offenses are so tuned up and usually have the ability to strike almost at will. And when you're only giving up three, you feel like it's almost like basketball. You're trading, right? I give up three on my end. I'm counting my offense to get six on the other, and that is a win.
Yeah, it's a win for the kicker, too, I guess, if he makes a field goal, right?
No doubt about it. He feels good about things, but his team feels like they settled.
A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch, too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Final minute now of the third quarter. On second down, Roethlisberger going deep here for Bryant. And this is caught. It's Bryant, and it's a Steeler touchdown. Martavis Bryant, 33 yards. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
We see this route all the time, but when it's well executed, it's a beauty.
And it feels like the fade takes forever to develop, like that ball is just hanging in the air.
And the reason why is that the receiver is trying his best to work the defender inside and give himself space to fade away from him and catch the football. And that's exactly what happened there.
Boswell on now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage to be found.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Pittsburgh, it's Charger football, but they trail here as we get going in quarter number four. Rivers now on second down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Antonio Gates, the veteran tight end, was the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down.
It's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Third and long for Rivers. And the Steeler pressured too much here. He's going down. Bud Dupree coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it'll be fourth down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And no, it's incomplete. The fourth down play doesn't work for the Chargers. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good one.
And this is caught. It's Bryant. And it's a Steeler touchdown. Martavis Bryant, his second touchdown of the night. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is... is it bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Boswell on now to kick this one away. It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Chargers. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term compliment?
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Ryan Shazier in there to get him again. The third time he sacked him here tonight.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching?
Try to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger, and he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about.
Pass interference.
And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty. No question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty would
do for
them?
I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Boswell on now to kick this one away. On the return, it's Isaiah Burse. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks right near the 27th. The Chargers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Now a second down throw for Rivers. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that.
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Melvin Gordon, a 16-yard touchdown run. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. And certainly some credit there for that touchdown goes to the offensive line.
They never get the credit they deserve in the stat sheet, but they are the reason that they got the points. Excellent job up front, clearing the way for the score.
Just a four-play drive that time, and it's capped off by a touchdown run coming from Melvin Gordon. And this doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. He sets to fire deep and almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let
Martavis Bryant and into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Martavis Bryant, 46 yards. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
A second down throw for Rivers. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. James Harrison in there to get him the sixth time they've sacked him tonight.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
Now Rivers. And this is going to be incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. Now the Steelers' offense gets ready to get back onto the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right, and sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell, just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Again, it's Bell. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
And the offense in a great spot. It's first and goal from the 3. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop it behind the line. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that'll make it second and goal.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers, neither side. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Xavier Grimble, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead.
I've got a laugh here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Virtual guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Here comes the Chargers offense now back out onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge. And someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. First and 10, Rivers, wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. One last shot now for Rivers. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game.
Well, partner, there's something special about a game in the snow. Just always fun in these elements, although a little chillier up here in the open air booth. The only thing that's not fun is that we got the mid-game notification that our flight was canceled tonight, but we'll deal with that later. It was really a fun game to watch, though.
It was, and there is something special about games played in the snow because the element of surprise really kicks in. You don't know how they're going to handle the ball, if someone's going to make a dramatic play just out of nowhere, and all of a sudden it just changes the course of things. But a big shout out to our crew to make sure that we were comfortable up here, as comfortable as one could be in these elements. They took care of us and made sure we were dressed properly.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Heinz Field.